Windows Explorer is missing. What do I do? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's the question I got some time ago. Microsoft malicious software removal tool seems to have removed Windows Explorer in my Windows. What can I do? So it's extremely rare that an anti-malware tool like the malicious software tool will remove Windows Explorer. As we'll see in a minute, it's a pretty fundamental part of Windows. However, it can happen. So there are a couple of things that I want to walk you through that will help you diagnose exactly what is going on and what you can do about it. Here's Windows 11. And as you can tell, it's a big black screen. There's nothing going on. You can probably see my mouse moving around, but that's about it. If I hit the Start key, nothing happens. That's because Explorer's not running. If you can hit the Start key and the taskbar shows up, then Explorer has not been removed because it's explorer.exe that actually manages the taskbar and the Start menu. So as we can see in this case, yeah, it's not there. I can't do that. So what do we do? Well, the thing to do is to go Control-Alt-Delete. It's been a while since we've used that keystroke. Then we'll run and click on Task Manager. I'm using Windows 11, so we'll click on Run New Task. In prior versions, you would hit the File menu, and there would also be a New Task or a Run option on the File menu. Click that, and I'm just going to type in Explorer and hit OK. And now all of a sudden, our desktop is back, the Start menu is back, the taskbar is back, Explorer is back. It had not been removed from our system. Now, if in a situation like this, Explorer had not come back, then we would have done something else. In fact, I'm actually going to make Explorer go away. I'll do what I did to start this. If I click on Explorer here in the Details view in Task Manager and say End Task, poof, I'm back to an empty desktop and no Start menu. In fact, I can hit the Windows key, but the Start menu never comes up. This time, we'll run a different task. I'm going to assume for some reason that explorer.exe didn't exist, that for whatever reason, I tried to run it and it gave me an error of not being found. This time, instead, the new task that I'm going to run is /scan now. That is the system file checker. And in fact, for this one, I'm going to go ahead and create it with administrative privileges, just so that it has all the power that it needs to potentially replace files that need replacing. And off it goes. It is running the system scan. It will take a little bit of time. I'll let it complete. The important thing here is that what SFC does is it actually looks for missing and damaged files in Windows itself and restores them from a backup copy. In this case, if explorer.exe is truly missing, SFC should be able to restore it. Now, what if SFC fails? Well, then things get complicated. As if SFC cannot restore explorer.exe, and it's literally not on your system, then you actually have very few options. You could try to do a repair install of Windows using bootable installation media, because without explorer.exe, there's a whole lot of stuff you can't do. So you'll actually need to boot from recovery media or installation media and then run the repair tools from that. The other option, of course, and this is something that I keep saying over and over and over again, if you'd had a backup, you'd simply restore the backup image from before this problem having started. If this problem was due to malware, then the backup image would not have the malware that potentially caused this. So this is another case where your backup image acts as a safety net and would allow you to deal with a number of the issues that are related to things like explorer.exe having gone missing. But as we can see here, SFC is cleaning up. It's not going to find anything because nothing's broken. I forced the issue. So since we forced the issue, I'll do what I did again. Explorer as the new task, and boom, I've got my desktop, my Start menu, and my taskbar all back again. Hope that's helpful. For comments, for updates, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/12548. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.